I'm not breaking any laws, I'm not trespassing. In fact, this is for my own protection. So these are all basically my covert cameras. I've got quite an assortment of covert glasses. These ones are really good. So I'm filming you now. And the button cameras actually just come through and pop in through the buttonhole. What I also carry is various handbags, and I have wired in button cameras and pinhole cameras in my accessories. It's a lot of gear, it's incredibly expensive, and we're doing the job that the Australian government should be doing.
Shartha Hamadi is a lawyer for Animals Australia. For years, she's been travelling overseas undercover, armed with covert cameras, hoping to expose animal cruelty. She's usually behind the lens. Now she's turning it on herself.
There is a deep sense of injustice that I feel about what is going on. It's just not acceptable. And I'm not speaking as an activist. I'm not speaking as some crazy, bleeding heart person that the live export companies want you to believe that I am. I'm not that person. I'm about justice and I'm about doing what's right.
Almost a decade ago, Shartha captured this footage of sheep being illegally sold in the Middle East, which was aired by 7:30.
Australia flag.
In 2011, the Australian government brought in regulations aimed at ending scenes like these. It's called the Exporter Supply Chain Assurance System, or ESCAS. The system requires exporters to ensure their animals are only handled, sold and slaughtered in approved facilities, like this one, filmed by an exporter and aired on ABC Landline. In May this year, Shartha travelled to Oman. She says the footage she gathered in a six-week operation shows the system is failing.
This is Australian sheep?
Yeah, so what you're seeing here is a line of trust Australian sheep. Their front legs are tied together, their back legs are tied together, and they're basically just all over the ground in between buyers, cattle, goats, being trampled on, as you can see, being dragged into the back of car boots.
So this one's being dragged?
Yes, this one's going home for private slaughter in the back of this car. By the way, it was over 40 degrees Celsius. The heat is stifling.
How can you be sure that they're Australian sheep when they have no ear tags in?
Australian merino sheep, Australian sheep, are incredibly unique from around the world in terms of the fact that they don't have tails, their face, their wool, the notches in their ears, etc.
Shartha claims she documented evidence showing hundreds of Australian sheep were available for sale outside of approved supply chains. In this video, captured on a button camera at a different location, Shartha is posing as a buyer at what she says is an approved feedlot.
I'm having a conversation with the staff member there, and I said to him, I just want to inquire about buying Australian sheep for private slaughter to take home. And he said, sure, how many do you want?
In late May and early June, Shartha sent evidence to the Department of Agriculture that she alleged showed Australian sheep were being sold outside of approved supply chains. It included GPS coordinates and even links to online ads showing Australian sheep listed for sale on Oman's version of Gumtree. On the 21st of June, the department announced it was investigating allegations from Animals Australia of non-compliance for sheep in Oman, saying it had taken regulatory action requiring exporters to implement stronger control arrangements, extra surveillance, and additional reporting.
The federal government had everything available to them to instruct and direct the exporters to go and secure the supply chains and get the Australian sheep out of these illegal facilities before the Festival of Sacrifice.
The Festival of Sacrifice, an annual religious event marked by slaughtering animals and sharing the meat, was on the 28th of June.
This was the morning of the Festival of Sacrifice. This is another non-approved facility. As you can see, filthy conditions, trussed sheep being dragged onto the kill floor and being slaughtered basically right next to each other, practically on top of each other. How could they lose control of the supply chain so blatantly?
My understanding is that the department, as the independent regulator, has been undertaking this investigation quite quickly and quite properly. It has already taken some regulatory action against the exporters who are involved, pending the final results of that investigation.
Animals Australia says it has not given the department the footage it captured during the festival.
Why haven't you provided the federal government with the footage you captured during the Festival of Sacrifice?
We provided the federal government, the regulator, with extensive formal complaints and legal complaints, which basically documented GPS locations, very comprehensive audio and visual evidence, the online selling that was happening, all of the URLs, the phone numbers, the videos that were being advertised, etc. The federal government had everything available to them. We could not have possibly done anything more to report this situation to the Australian government.
Animals Australia says they will supply the footage to the department this week.
I'll show you this footage and maybe if you could sort of explain to me what you're seeing.
Sure.
and how that differs from what should be going on under the SCAS regime.
Those images are obviously very concerning. You know, I haven't seen them before. They obviously have to be verified.
The Agriculture Department is still investigating Animals Australia's allegations.
The figures show that there's a very small percentage of cases in which the SCAS regime is not complied with, and in the overwhelming majority of cases it is.
So do we need to accept that this is always going to happen?
Well, as I say, I'm not sure that any government can ever put in place a system that is going to work 100% of the time.
Is it effectively an honour system?
No, I mean, there is obviously some monitoring of what goes on here.
But are they in country watching what's going on in the importing countries?
Yeah, I mean, ultimately the exporters are responsible for meeting the SCAS standards. The whole point of SCAS is to place responsibility on exporters.
So it is an honour system in
well,
that sense?
Well, there is also some monitoring that is undertaken from the department and including also independent observers that go on live export vessels, which is another part of the system as well. But we do place primary responsibility on exporters to make sure that they're doing the right thing.
An independent panel set up by the federal government was already working on a roadmap for ending live sheep exports.
I don't necessarily see this as vindication of our position, but, you know, I think it is another example that shows there are some issues when it comes to the export of live sheep. That's why we took that position heading into the election.
The release of this footage from Animals Australia comes at a time when WA farmers are fighting to stop a planned phase-out of live sheep exports by the federal government. Almost all of the sheep leaving Australian shores come from WA, loaded on ships here in Fremantle. The WA government has warned that ending the trade could cost the state's agricultural industry up to $123 million annually and cut 400 jobs across the supply chain.
I don't think we need to accept that Western Australia experiences that kind of dollar impact, because I think there are things that can be done to reduce that impact.
Labor first promised to end live sheep exports in 2018 after hundreds of them died in sweltering conditions on their way to the Middle East. Nationals leader David Littleproud was the agriculture minister at the time and oversaw reforms that have improved the conditions on board the ships. He's vowing to keep live sheep exports alive if the coalition wins the next federal election.
We've gone from a mortality methodology to an animal welfare methodology. We measure the pants per minute of a sheep on those boats. We measure the airflow going through an individual boat, the weight of the sheep before it gets on the boat, and to the millimetre, the length of wool on that sheep.
How would you clean up SCAS further to stop Australian sheep being inhumanely handled and slaughtered outside of approved supply chains.
Yeah, and this is where leakage out of the supply chain has been an issue even when I was the Agriculture Minister, because we're obviously in country, we're in someone else's nation. So it's important about making sure you have that relationship with those nations to be able to forge those standards, and proudly we've been able to achieve that.
I've seen footage of them being dragged, put in boots of cars, slaughtered on concrete slabs. Is that what world-leading animal welfare standards should look like?
No, that's where we have now have the opportunity, because of the relationship we have, to go and to fix that up. We wouldn't have that opportunity if we don't send our sheep there, if we don't have that influence.
The industry body representing live exporters declined an interview with 7:30, saying it supports the regulatory process and does not want to prejudice the department's ongoing investigation. 7:30 also contacted the two companies exporting sheep to Oman. Only one replied, Retwa, which told us it was aware of the allegations made about Australian sheep identified outside registered supply chains, and it would continue to work with DAF as they conduct their investigations.
Some people will see this, perhaps they're completely removed from the issue, and think, well, animals are for eating, and who are we to tell another country how they should do that?
We know now what's happening to the animals. We know that they suffer greatly. So it's really a question about, can we pioneer to the rest of the world that we don't accept these practices? I will continue to investigate this trade for as long as Australia continues to send live sheep into these countries.